Hello guys, my name is Bastard and in this video I want to show you my Spark Inquisitor build version 3.6, also called the Freezing Spark Inquisitor. The build is viable for many leagues now, but with the buffs to Spark Inquisitor and Energy Shield, the build feels faster, stronger and better than ever before. The build has very good balance between clear speed, single target DPS and survivability. The character in the video is level 92 and the gear is worth about 5 to 6 exalted orbs. So there is still a lot of room for improvements. With more investment, the build is viable to do all content. Many players already killed Uber Elder, even Deathless this season. In this video I just want to give you a short overview over this build and I will show you the most important details of this build. I will concentrate on the Covenant setup, which is in my opinion the best at the moment. In the written guide you can find much more gearing options and much more detailed description and information of this build. Now I want to talk a bit about the main skill of this build, Spark. I just fell in love with this skill the first time I saw it. It is so damn cool to see all these little sparks or spiders with the MTX to run around the screen and crush all enemies. For this build we use a Wall Spark gem which gives us the normal Spark skill, which is our main skill, and the Wall Spark skill. The Wall Spark can be used for faster clear speed or to burst down bosses. It is always important to know how the mechanics of skills work, so I will explain them a bit. I will start with the Spark skill gem tags. Spell and Lightning means that you can scale the spark damage with spell and lightning damage modifiers. Projectile means that you can scale the damage with modifiers to projectile damage and you can improve the speed the spark travels with projectile speed. You also can increase the amount of spark projectiles with for example the helm enchantment or a spark threshold javel. Duration determines how long a spark exists, which is important because a spark can hit the same enemy every 0.66 seconds, so with increased duration a spark can hit enemies multiple times. You should also be aware that Spark will be destroyed after traveling a distance of 150 units away from the character. There are also two annoying mechanics, bugs about Spark you should know about. The first one is, Spark is a ground-based skill and cannot hit some flying enemies. The second one, if you cast Spark while you are too near to objects, Spark will do this. More or less, the build is based on the Inquisitor Ascendancy and the synergies with Grit, Energy Shield and Life. We use a Call of the Brotherhood Ring to convert some of our lightning damage to cold and create a shield of freezing sparks around us. Now you can see a build overview which has the most important details of this build and also can be used as a leveling template. With this overview I try to explain the Ascendancy, the skill tree progression, skill setups, Pantheon and how to deal with the bandits. Let's take a quick look at the Ascendancy progression. First we go for Sanctify and Bias Path for great survivability, damage and sustain. As soon as you get Bias Path you want to spec into Eldritch Battery and Mind Over Matter, which will solve all your mana problems early on. When you get the Covenant Body Armor, we will drop Eldritch Battery and Mind Over Matter to fully profit from the protection of our Energy Shield. As long as you have Eldritch Battery and Mind Over Matter, your Energy Shield should be about a third of your life pool. Then we go for Inevitable Judgment for crazy DPS boost with crits. Inevitable Judgment allows our crits to ignore enemies' resistances. That means the enemy's resistances are always set to zero. You cannot reduce the resistances below that. From this point on, the build can be scaled crazy with crit chance and multipliers. Let's take a look on the skill tree progression. More or less, just follow the numbers and pick all nodes up on the way. Before we invest heavy into grid, I would recommend to go for elemental overload, which should be dropped as soon as you get more grid. Please don't follow the skill tree progression blindly. You should go for life energy nodes when you feel squishy, and when you feel you need more TPS, go for damage nodes on the skill tree. I highly recommend to use one Spark Threshold Javel, which makes Spark to be cast in a Nova, gives additional projectiles and damage. An Intuitive Leap Javel is used to get overcharged, which provides us with all charges while mapping. The last Javel slot I use normally for a Javel with Onslaught on Kill, which improves the clear speed a lot. The main skill is Spark, and while Spark can be used to increase clear speed or burst down bosses in seconds, I would recommend to use following support gem order: Spell Echo, Energy Leech, Control Destruction, Added Lightning Damage, Hypothermia or Increased Critical Damage. I would recommend to use Hypothermia as the last link. If you decide to use a Mark of the Shaper Ring instead of Call of the Brotherhood, I would recommend to use Increased Critical Damage instead. The build uses two different cast and damage taken setups for defense, one low level for a high proc rate and one with high level gems. For movement speed I decided to go with Flame Dash linked with faster casting and low level Arcane Surge. Arcane Surge should proc every time when Flame Dash is used. The build uses also an Orb of the Storm setup, which provides us with power charges while boss fights, will finish up bosses when they reach 10% with cooling strike, and should also be placed near bosses because the bolts released from the orb when you use a lightning skill can push your DPS by quite a bit. If you use an Elder or Shaper item which gives the orb additional damage support, it becomes even more powerful. Now I want to tell you how to burst down bosses in seconds. Often it is just a matter of timing to activate all damage stuff at the same time. I normally start to put down the Orb of Storm in the range of the boss, then activate Val Haste and Val Spark. Activate all damage flask and spam Spark, and normally the boss melts just in seconds. I decided to go with Soul of Solaris and Soul of Tukuhama to avoid one-shots and to help Alira for additional resistances and crit multiplier. On gear look mainly for following stats: life, energy shield, resistances, crit chance, crit multipliers, spell, lightning and elemental damage, cast speed, damages, extra chaos. Don't use too many units because you will need about 4 to 5 raw gear pieces to cap your elemental and chaos resistances and push your life and energy shield pool. On raw gear I would really focus to get high life, energy shield and resistances rolls, and if you can afford it you can try to get some DPS stats as well. As weapon I would recommend a Cerberus Limb as budget option. For higher budget, a Wrath Scepter or Dagger with high spell damage, crit multiplier, cast speed, critical strike chance to spells and other nice stats. On the helmet, more or less all spark enchantments are good options. I would say the best option is 3 additional spark projectiles, then projectile speed and then spark damage, but I guess that is a matter of taste. I would recommend to use following specific gear and units: the Covenant body armor for blood magic for our spark setup, which allows us to drop Eldritch Battery and Mind Over Matter and get the full protection from our energy shield. You also need an Enlightened level 3 linked with your mana reserving skills. The additional damage boost of the Chaos support is also very nice. Then Voidwalkers allow us to drop Pierce out of our spark setup and replace it with a support which gives a lot more DPS. Call of the Brotherhood to convert some of our lightning damage to cold and become a freezing spark inquisitor. The next units and items are also highly recommended, but also can be replaced easy by something else. Jaw of the Storm is crazy good for DPS, especially for single targets. Shadows and Dust for Rampage and to push our clear speed. A Elder Ring with Warlord's Mark on hit is very important for survivability and sustain. I use a Life Flask with Anti-Bleed, a Diamond Flask for Crazy Boost to DPS and a Quicksilver Flask for Great Clear Speed, which can be dropped for DPS Flask on hard boss fights. Additionally, I use a Cinder Swallow Urn, which is just super strong for DPS, and a Tears Promise, which helps with survivability, sustain and gives a good amount of DPS. Thank you guys for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video and I would really appreciate it if you could leave me a like and subscribe to my channel. In the description of this video you can find the link to the written guide where you always can find the latest version of this build and other useful information. I hope I have not forgotten anything too important. If you have any questions, you always can ask them as a comment to the video guide or as a reply to the written guide. The community and I try to answer as soon as we can. Now following the rest of the T16 Phoenix map run without commentary. Have fun, farm like gods, and see you soon!
To the sound of screaming. My eyes in the dark smoke billows into the hut from the outside. I dash outside and I'm confronted by a wall of heat. Smoke makes it difficult to see, but the village is in flames. We're trapped! A rival tribe stands at the only exit, cutting my brothers and sisters down as they flee. We've been ambushed! I run towards the flames and leap, praying to Valarka for protection.
This is the key to a crucible that stretches the sanity of the mind.